Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Don't Fear The Spreadsheet podcast, episode number 16, chart and table. Well, hey, welcome back to the Don't Fear The Spreadsheet podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel with today's question. Here's Tyler Nash.
I'm like super, super pressed for time. Is there any way that I can set up a chart and a table simultaneously or no?
Chart and table simultaneously. I just wish the answer was no. The answer is yes. Yes, you can. But I hate the options. Okay, so here's our chart. We come back here to the layout tab. You have to click the chart to get to the layout tab. So if you click outside the chart, no layout tab, click inside the chart, layout tab is back. Data table. We have none. Yes. Show data table. Show data table with legend keys. Let's compare. Show data table has a little data table down there. Woohoo! Data table, show data table with legend keys, which would allow us to get rid of the legend, which would make a little bit more space, I guess. Although now this breaks the rule because now the legend is at the bottom instead of at the top. Here's why I don't like data tables. Boy, that seems really, really busy down there. I'd like to do a little bit of formatting to it, and let's see what we can do. So I go click on the data table and format data table. Oh, change the fill, change the border color, I can add a shadow. There's nothing in here that lets me change the number format. I can turn the borders on or off. I just don't feel like I have a lot of control here. And if I want to change the number format, I have to come back here and change the number format. So for example, I'm going to use Control 1 to get to format cells. That's the same as clicking this little dialog or a little dialog launcher. Control 1. Go to the number tab, thousand separator, zero decimal points, and I even want to do the little trick to put it in thousands. So comma, the comma puts it in thousands. K adds a little K afterwards. You see, then that screws up my legend here. I have to come back here and change the legend, and it just seems like I don't have a lot of control. And if you know me, I like to have control. So the data table, it's really easy to do. I mean, this could have been a 3-second podcast. Yeah, Tyler, click here. But it's just, it frustrates me to no end that I don't seem to have the control that I want with the data table. So, a couple of options. One, choose a series, layout, data labels, outside in, and then do some formatting. So, you know, that way you kind of have the data table right there on top of the chart. That's option number one. I want to go into the next worksheet. Option number two is, Tyler, you already had a data table in order to create the chart. So what's the need to use that horrible looking data table when you can already format this one however you like? So, you know, here I used cell styles and my favorite heading 4. I even went into more borders. So that's under borders, more borders. And I could change the color and exactly whichever borders I wanted. If there was one cell that I wanted to highlight, like right here, July is way up. Something good happened there in July. I can add a little bit of some sort of cell formatting to that. And then if I want that table to appear below the chart, we'll just insert a bunch of rows here. I was about to use Alt-IR. Sorry, insert. Shoot. Insert, and then drag the chart up to fit that spot. Didn't quite work. A few more rows. Alt-IR. Old habits are hard to break. All right, set the print range. Fit to one page wide. All right, so now I actually have a chart and a table that I can absolutely control. So while that took a little bit more time than just going to layout, data table, and you know, choosing one of their couple of options there, you have so much more control using this method. Well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. Check out the book, Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. This is the book that makes Excel for Dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.